Dear IBM Newsletter reader, I'm happy to be here in front of you, even if it's only on a video. And I wanted to give you an overview about the activities of IBM in the last 3 months. Let's start with the policy. The policy is our core business in IBM. And I want to give you a very short focus on three main points. First, the energy union. You probably have heard about this concept. And the challenge for us is really to convince member states to develop renewables, because there is only voluntary targets for 2030 at the member states level, and really with what we call the governance, we would hope to have a kind of pledge from the member states to develop renewables, what is quite challenging to achieve, but at least we would like to really have a monitoring and the commission pushing the member states to act in the right direction. The second point for the policy is the heating and cooling strategy, also discussed for the moment. And there we also have a challenge, because we don't really like this concept of a low carbon economy, because it is less stronger than the concept to develop renewables, and really renewables are part of the three no regret option of the Commission for 2050, and is really the way to go according to us in the heating and cooling strategy. And the third policy files that we are following actively is related to the buildings, and the new buildings are regulated now in the Energy Performance of Buildings Directive that is rediscussed. And really for this we would prefer that the member states would really implement the existing measures than trying to reshuffling the whole thing for the time being at least. Second main activity of IBM are the statistics, and for the statistics we just released on the 20th of October our full statistical report, and a very nice piece of work, more than 300 pages, with a lot of course bioenergy statistics, including a comprehensive chapter on the support schemes, more than 100 pages, that will allow investors to better understand the market conditions in all the member states. So really interesting. And then you can also find on the website another the short version, the key findings, mainly aiming at a larger dissemination for policymakers, for bioenergy stakeholders, giving the summary of the full report. The third large aspects of IBM activities is the communication. We are really proud of our new website, just launched a few weeks ago. That is much more interactive. You can find video and a lot of documents on this. And we also are busy for the moment with the Biomass Counts campaign. It's a campaign that we launched earlier this year, aiming at giving really positive communication arguments about bioenergy. We, for example, organized in October an event on jobs and innovations, where we really highlighted the fact that bioenergy has created 500,000 jobs in Europe already, and this space can continue for the future for sure. We are also proud in this campaign to have been accepted by the COP21 organizers for a workshop on the 1st of December in Paris, in the COP21 facilities, that will focus on the climate change impact of biomass. And you might know that the carbon accounting of biomass is also a hot topic for the moment. This is not the only event that we are going to organize in the coming weeks. There is another one on pellets for the medium scale use, a very important market. The potential for growth is really important, and there will be investors and plant managers telling their story there on this workshop on the 17th of November. Thank you for listening to me and a happy reading of this this new newsletter. And I hope to see you on the 17th of November for this Pellets event or the 1st of December in Paris for the COP21 event.